Splicing animal DNA has become quite a hobby. And as you've been asking, I've taken my frog here to my laboratory at home and spliced his DNA using crude equipment with an owl egg. Here it is heating up in my lab. When the owl hatched from his egg, it was no longer an owl, but a frog owl. This creature was far more dangerous than I had expected, and I needed gloves and a full suit to handle him. I set him free, but he kept returning to my home. Look at his eyes. This creature is one of the most amazing things I've ever created. Thanks for watching. Follow for part 2. Today I'll be showing you my pig and squirrel animal hybrid. As always, this started with extracting DNA from my pet squirrel and splicing it with the DNA from my pet pig in my home laboratory. When the babies came out, they were so small and cute and lovable. But when they grew up, this is what they looked like. Although they have skin like a pig, they're very much so still squirrels, and this is a work in progress. They're so happy, and they're loved. Growing up on my farm, my two favorite animals were always pigs and bunnies, and I always wondered what it would be like if I combined bunny and pig DNA together to create an entirely new species. And so that is what I did with my pet bunny and my pet pig here. I took samples of their DNA to my home laboratory, and I combined them to create an entirely new species of animal. This is what they look like as a baby. They're so cute. And as you can see, they retained their pig-like features while adopting a bunny-shaped body and ears. It's furless, and as you can see, it's a bit faster than a pig. I release these guys back in the wild, but they always come back for food. Follow for part 2. Growing up on a farm, my favorite animals were always moles and ducks, and I wanted to make a mole-duck hybrid. So I took the DNA from my pet mole, and I spliced it with the DNA from my pet ducks here. After the eggs hatched, this is what they looked like. I made one of the coolest animals. It almost looks like Pikachu. It's so lovable and friendly, and I've been selling them for about $10. The ones that I don't sell, I release back into the wild. Thanks for following. Bye. Growing up, one of my favorite cartoon shows was Pokemon, and I always wanted a real-life Pikachu. And so I took an albino squirrel here, and I spliced his DNA with an electric eel. But I needed yellow for his color, and so I took DNA from baby chickens. I took them to my laboratory, and you would not believe what I made.
Gotta never love one like you.
This cute little creature is my first attempt at creating a Pikachu. It is so lovable and fun. He's so beautiful. Follow for part 2 to see my progress. This is my second attempt of trying to create an Easter Bunny. And like the first, I started with DNA from my personal chickens. I then took the DNA from our family pet bunny. He is so cute and lovable. The DNA was taken to my laboratory where we fertilized eggs. And although it didn't come out as I expected, it did come out amazing. My Easter bunny is more like a chicken than a bunny, but he looks like a bunny. As you can see, he has bunny-like fur instead of feathers, and he hobbles around like a bunny. Although this isn't what I expected and what I wanted, I am one step closer to creating a real Easter bunny. In my quest to make a real dinosaur, I thought I would do a little experimenting with a little snake I found in my home garden. This little lucky guy wound up being more useful than I thought he would be. So I took his DNA, and with the help from my wife, we took our jellyfish from our seaquarium, to the lab inside of our home. Extracting jellyfish DNA is not as hard as you may think it is. And as you can see, we're well equipped for the job. And so we took the eggs and put them in our little seaquarium here. The results were astounding. As you can see, we wound up with a jellyfish-like snake. It was something from out of this world. Not exactly sure what to call it, but we ended up bringing it back and putting it in nature where it belongs. Thank you for watching. I've always wanted to make a real dinosaur, and so this is what I did. I took the DNA from my chicken from the first video I made, and I spliced it with DNA from my pet bearded dragon here. This process only took about 24 hours. Here is what it looks like under a microscope.
I follow you into the
park, as you can see, the eggs came out perfectly.
God, I never loved one like you.
Although I have a long ways to go before I create a real life velociraptor. Although their legs are very scaly, like that of a dinosaur, they are very much clearly still chickens.
Nothing new is sweeter than
follow for part two. Growing up, I was always fascinated with dragons, and I wanted to see if I could make one for my own. So I took the DNA of one of my pet water snakes here, and I spliced his DNA with my pet salamander. The results weren't as good as I expected. They were still amazing. As you can see, I made a snake-like creature with arms and legs. It breathes underwater, but it swims like a snake. I'm still a long ways away from finishing my creation, but I think it turned out pretty cool.
Nothing new is sweeter than with you.
Since we're coming up on Easter, I wanted to share with you one of my favorite creations of all time. I was fascinated by the Easter Bunny as a child, and so I decided to make one for my own. So I took my pet bunny into my laboratory, and I decided to splice his DNA with my chicken here. And after my chicken had laid an egg, the results were astounding. As you can see here, we have a bunny-chicken hybrid. This is a bunny that walks like a chicken, but plays like a bunny. They eat like maniacs. They are so cute and playful. They love humans. The best part about these little guys is that they too lay eggs. I sell these for $5. Growing up, my favorite cartoon was always CatDog, and I always wondered how awesome it would be if we made a real-life CatDog. And that is exactly what I set out to do. And with the help of my personal pet, Charger, and my best friend's feline, we extracted their DNA and took it back to my personal laboratory at home, where I spent the next 9 months splicing cat and dog DNA into what would be the world's first cat-dog hybrid. And the results are absolutely breathtaking. Notice the canine features with the soft cat-like fur and ears. Notice also the whiskers. And as you'll see, these cat dogs play like cats and dogs. These are on the market currently for $200. Thank you. I've always wanted to mix the DNA of an insect with a mammal, and that is exactly what I did when I took this pill bug and I extracted its DNA and mixed it with a mole. What's so interesting about this animal is that it's not only an insect, but it's also a mammal. The results were astounding. As you can see, the mole developed a bright white fur, but retained its armor. This beautiful creature is on the market right now for $20,000. One of my favorite animals that I've made so far was a cat mixed with a bird. And you won't believe it, but bird DNA and cat DNA are very similar, and their bone structure made it very easy to have favorable results. So just as I did with the chicken, I extracted the DNA from a cat, which was quite easy, and I spliced it with DNA from a chicken, like the ones from the videos before. The results were absolutely breathtaking. As you can see, I've successfully developed cats with wings, and although they can't fly, they still function as normal cats, except they have wings. I've sold hundreds of these all over the world, and I hope you love them. After my chicken video went viral, I wanted to show you all the rest of the animals that I've been creating over the years. I wanted to mix the DNA of a pig with a frog, and that is exactly what I did with the help of my family on our farm. I took the DNA from a frog, and I took the DNA from a pig, and they blended perfectly together. The end result was astounding. After 8 days, the eggs were finally coming together. Although it looks like a frog, it clearly has the characteristics of a pig, and they're not that great at swimming, but boy are they happy. I've made about 200 of them so far, and I'm taking orders on my website. Thank you so much. Growing up, my two favorite animals were always dogs and frogs. I always wanted to combine them to make a hybrid frog dog. With a little help from my chemistry professor, that is exactly what I did. Frog DNA and dog DNA splice perfectly together. And as you can see, they're perfectly healthy and happy. They're so happy and they love to hop around. They're so fun. I love these little guys. One of the best parts about all of this is I have been able to give hundreds of dog frogs to loving families who have taken care of them and given them happy, hoppy homes. Street, we run a free like it's only you and me. Jesus, you have something to see. Oh, let me go home.